You don't even need them.
That's true. That's true.
They're not going to match the person who left you last time.
Come on, sir.
Oh, help me here right now. But he ain't not meant to. Well, Junior, go on. Thank God that he has someone say amen.
Amen.
They're not going to be able to match what you want them to match. So you got to start making adjustments. If you want your team to, am I talking to y'all here? If you want your team to win, you got to look at the players on your team and you got to design a game plan. Glory to God. If you know your wife's not going to make the bed, go hire somebody to clean the house. Go get your husband. Oh, y'all ain't talk to me here. Go get your husband and tell him, oh, you didn't make the bed and they ain't seen him make it for 20 years. Go find someone.
Glory to God. Glory.
I'm preaching good here. I don't know if y'all get the concept of what I'm talking about. If you want to be a leader, you have to take the team that God gives you, and you can't make them fit the system. That, come on, you got to create. See, first of all, you got to stay with them long enough to figure out who they are. So now you run away from them and run them away before you know how good they can be to you.
Yes, amen to that.
Speak on it. Speak on it.
I don't have anybody here.
Yes,
God. Let's touch it. Take your time. Take your time. Learn where their strengths are. Learn where their weaknesses are. Learn what they like. See, some of y'all are relationships, you don't even know what a person like. You just trying to get them to like what you like. And you don't even know what they like. Boy, y'all ain't talk to me here. You don't know what they like. You don't know what they like to eat. All you know is you like steaks. So everybody, that's how we eat steaks. The devil is a lie. What if they like chicken? What if they like fish or something? Every now and then you guys say, okay, I know you like fish, baby. We go to the fish market and get some fish.
Right. Come on.
Glory. Had a preacher one time. I use Crest toothpaste. And nobody in the house ain't using another Crest toothpaste. And destroy the whole family behind it. Oh, I'm getting to somebody like this. Like, y'all say no better than coming to church. Bro. Y'all say no better than coming to church. You know God will put y'all there every time. Someone say amen. What difference does it make what kind of toothpaste somebody uses?
That's
true. If they like Colgate, buy Colgate! Instead of one big tube, buy two small ones!
That's right. Come on.
Let me get back to this message here.
Come on,
I just need to help somebody with that.
Glory.
If you give me the team to run, you're not going to have success trying to make all the people conform to you.
That's true.
Are we talking here? But you have to figure out who they are and what they like.
Praise
hallelujah. And one of the mistakes I made as a leader is putting people to lead stuff without figuring out what their strengths and weaknesses are.
Yes, sir.
Y'all ain't talking to me here. Some of y'all better retire. So now, see, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to make an adjustment even at my home. I have to learn. See, the Lord told me to start driving because, you know, it's easy to complain. Someone say amen.
Yes, it is.
If you don't say amen now, you're a hypocrite, you're lying. But you complained this week, amen?
Yes, God.
And the Lord began to show me, said, I know I'm off the message, but I need to have somebody there. He said, you don't understand, man. If I put you in authority anywhere, in your home, at your job, at the church, trust that what I said you is supposed to be there.
That's right. That's true. Amen.
Jesus.
Since when you got saved, I took control of your life, right? I'm helping some of y'all in here. See, that's why some of y'all can't understand the separations that you go through sometimes. The Bishop Jake said, one of the things about being successful in Christ is painful separation. That's a part of it, baby. God put them in, and he take them out, and it's time for them to go. I said, listen, but I tell you all the time, when he take them out, let them go. Let them step on top of, oh, he ain't called me, she ain't called me, the devil is a lie. When you walked away, you spoke clearly to me that you didn't want to be a part of me anymore. So when you walked away, the Lord bless you. I see you around the side. Someone say amen.
Amen.
But if you hear, it is my job as a leader.
Yes, sir.
That's the truth.
God, am I getting in trouble?
That's the truth. All right, sir.
Not to do it by public opinion. God, talk to me here. See, that's the problem with some of you. I've seen in our family. You let the school system down to raise your children.
My goodness. Jesus.
And you know they don't care that much about your children. Y'all just don't accept that. All they care is that when they come to our seat, they represent a dog.
That's right.
So now as I know, shut up, I'm going to shout. Now as I choose to lead the people, I can't do this. See, it's a theocracy, this thing here. So I have to be hearing directly from God.
Amen.
So I can't disqualify you because Sister Jonah don't like you.
Yes.
Right. Go ahead, son. Right. I've lost all my
amens.
Amen. I didn't listen. I can't be an effective leader. What I have to do is sit and watch, sit and pray, sit and observe, and watch what's going on. See, you may not be good at prayer.
That's true.
Lord.
And you can't be disqualified just because you can't pray.
Come on. Oh, wow.
Jesus. You might be a well, way better servant, but don't know how to pray.
No, you're right. You're right.
God. And when folk would tell you, they shouldn't be in leadership because they don't pray.
Amen.
All right. Let me get back to this. Are we good?
Yes, sir.
Are we here?
Amen.
Remember now, that was just a little something I threw in on a leadership thing. But listen, man, listen. Listen as I talk to you. God is not going to do anything other than what he's already done. Hear me. You are on a journey that God has placed you on. And what God has done for you, I'm going to talk to you all just a minute. I'll get back to this meeting. God has poured out of himself into this environment everything that you need. Somebody talk to me here. Let me say it again. Everything that you need to do, everything that you need to do has been poured out to you out of the Spirit of God. Glory. Somebody say, I have it right now. And when God poured it out, he poured out all the grace that you need. He poured out all the mercy that you need. He poured out all the strength that you need. He poured out the revelation that you need. And more importantly, begin to take this morning, he poured out the anointing that you need.
Yes, sir.
You already have it all right now.
Yes, Lord.
But God's only going to do it his way. I feel like preaching.
Preaching.
I feel like preaching here. Let me say it again. You already have all things. You have everything you need to be the light of the world. You have the Word. You have the Holy Ghost dwelling in you. You have the Holy Ghost leading you. You have the Holy Ghost guiding you. You have everything that you need right now to walk in total victory. But what you're going to have to do is, you have to understand that God wants you to be a believer.
Yes, sir.
Am I in the right church here?
Yes, sir.
Someone say, I have it right now.
I have it right now.
And what the Lord showed me this morning is this, Izzy. See, because I was reading this scripture wrong, Vaughn, for so long. I was saying the Lord said to pour out my spirit. And that's how most of y'all read it. But he said, I will pour out of my spirit. He says, I'm going to dump out of myself onto you. Russia. Now here's what's interesting with that. He did that from the day of Pentecost. But that you know that the, when he said the day you hear my voice, do you know that you can decide today to receive that?
Yes.
My God, help me, Holy Spirit. If you understand me a little bit, see, I want you to get this because I'm going to stop this message and deal with this here today. Do you know if you believe what I'm saying, you can hear my voice, you can decide today to receive that thing which was released 2,000 years ago? Somebody's going to get saved today. Salvation was released 2,000 years ago. Somebody's going to get this outpouring today. But it was released 2,000 years ago. See, you can decide today, Father, I want that thing that you poured out, I want it all. And I'm going to receive it by faith. Glory to God. Yeah, my mind ain't lined up right with it, but I'm going to receive it by faith. My feeling don't tell me I deserve it, but I'm going to receive it by faith. I'm going to receive it because you released it. And the just shall live by faith. So now I know that I have the anointing. I know that I have the grace. I know that I have the power. I know that I have the narrative because it's been poured out, and I choose today to receive it. It's not going to happen. Anybody tired of church stuff?
Hey.
It's kind of hard for me to watch church on TV anymore because I'm just tired of all the emotions.
Come on, God.
I'm tired of all the cliches. I'm not knocking nobody's business, don't get me wrong. I'm just tired of all the emotions. What I want you to do is take an inventory of your life this morning.